Ja, wir kommen zurück zu Hellblade, Senua's Sacrifice.
The Northmen say that in the beginning there was nothing but darkness. Bitter cold to the north, fiery hot to the south. They say the cold formed ice, which melted from the sparks from the south. The power of the darkness gave life to the dripping ice, and the first giant was born and was named Ymir. The ice continued to drip, and the power of the void gave life to it, and it became a cow whose milk fed the giant. That's right, a cow, but you weren't expecting that.
Ja, Surt und Valravn, wir starten mit meinem absoluten Lieblingsgegner der beiden.
Valravn, ancestor of the seers and master of ravens. He hunts his prey with his powers of illusion and feasts on their remains. Follow the path to Valravn and defeat him in battle to earn his mark. The gate to Helheim cannot be opened without it.
Ymir was a frost giant, a being of darkness, and all his sons and grandsons were dark after him. Of his daughters and granddaughters, some were monstrous, but others fair. But there was another who came from the ice, Buri. In shape, he was like a man, big and powerful. His son, Bor, took a fair giant to be his wife, and they had three sons. Odin was the eldest, and the Northmen hold him to be the foremost of the gods, the All-Father. Illusion hides the path to Valravn. Don't trust your eyes. Find another way to see the truth.
What's that? It's a door.
We all want to see behind the veil, don't we? Once we do, we mostly just close our eyes again and pretend what we saw was never really there. Once you gaze into the relentless darkness, all that lurks within it can see you too.
against a wall.
She will find what she's looking for.
Valravn's power of illusion comes from ravens. Allowing the ravens to break his magic seal.
Show me what you have seen, Druth.
Look how much has changed.
Die Illusionen hier sind schon eine ganz besondere Technik, wie ich finde.
She can get up now.
She can get up now.
What's happening? She can get up now.
How can she get up?
Must be magic.
Dark magic.
A trick. not him.
It's a trick.
She's doing it on her own. He's not tricking her. It's magic.
It's an illusion.
Wir wollen doch schließlich alle Geschichten hören, nicht wahr?
The Northmen say that Odin has two ravens. Their names are Thought and Memory. And each day he sends them out to fly all across the world. Upon their return, they perch on his shoulders and tell him everything they have seen and heard. In this way, he learns of things far and wide, and for this reason, he is called the Raven God. Senua, like Odin, you must seek wisdom through thought and memory if you are to succeed in your quest.
Ja, neues in der Welt dieser nordischen Götter hier. Die Wahrheit nicht so leicht zu erkennen.
We picture fear, and we think of a shadow in the woods. Simple. The worst kind comes without warning. A deep and primal signal from within. A reminder that just because you cannot see the threat, it doesn't mean that it's not already here.
Find your own path a different way.
Behind you.
The Northmen say that Odin and his brothers killed Ymir, and that the world of men was formed from his corpse. They made his bones into stone, and his flesh into earth, and his blood into the salt sea. They set his skull to be the bowl of the sky, with his brains for clouds. Odin and his brothers caught the sparks flying from Muspel and made them into stars. And to protect the new world from the giants, they used Ymir's great curving eyebrows as walls.
Ja, und innerhalb dieser Augenbrauen leben wir hier in Midgard. Wer hätte das gedacht?
Do you know what it's like to leave everything behind? Your home, loved ones, to head deep into the wilds, perhaps never to return. Senua does. Because when darkness speaks, it changes everything. Turning home into a foreign land and loved ones into strangers. Exile makes sense when you realize that you were never really home in the first place.
There was a very wise being named Mimir, who guarded the waters of wisdom which flow from the roots of the world tree. Odin wished to drink from this spring, but he had to pay a price. So he gouged out his own eye as offering to Mimir. He drank from the well, and traded one way of seeing for another.
Ja, Odin hat ein Auge eingetauscht. Gegen große Weisheit. Wieso also mit zwei Augen sehen, wenn man mit einem viel besser sehen kann?
The wilds a long time ago.
Why did she go to the wilds?
She wanted to fight her own darkness. She thought she could beat her own.
Oh, did she beat her darkness?
No. It nearly killed her, but she tried.
Druth. Druth helped her.
If it wasn't for Druth, she'd be dead.
She can't beat her own darkness. She wanted to marry Dillian. She came to beat her own darkness and marry Dillian. But it didn't work.
She thought her curse would affect him.
She thought her curse would spread to him.
She thought she'd bring the darkness to him too.
She nearly died.
She thought the curse made her tainted.
Druth helped her.
Ja, ihr Lieben. Viele Tore haben wir nicht mehr vor uns. Den Weg zu Valraven werden wir uns nächste Woche, ja, wie soll ich das sagen, frei rätseln. Ihn ein bisschen mit unserer Illusion spielen lassen. Um ihn dann nächste Woche letztendlich gegenüberzustehen. Ich danke euch sehr fürs Zusehen an diesem ersten Wochenende mit Hellblade, Senua's Sacrifice. Ich hoffe, es hat euch gefallen. Sagt mir doch mal, ob es für euch blind ist, ob ihr es selbst gespielt habt, ob ihr es woanders geschaut habt. Für mich ist es nicht blind und ich freue mich sehr, euch auf diese Reise mitzunehmen. Vielen Dank. Habt einen schönen Sonntag. Bis nächste Woche.